Hey nerds, we're at day one of Computex 2019. We know about Ryzen 9, we know about Ryzen 7. Nobody really knows how it overclocks yet. But the only person that's gotten probably as close as we've gotten to actual performance is Brian from Down Under. Yes, Brian from Tech Yes City. Great channel. Please go and visit there. Love the audio reviews.
Yeah, love meeting you, man. It's always good to meet you in person.
But so. I want to know, Brian, you're the man who has intelligence, intel on what we're going to see out of the overclock of Ryzen.
So we're basically at the right place at the right time. I'm not going to divulge who and how.
Is it
and
Lisa
what.
With a mustache is what I was thinking?
Yeah, you know, okay. Like not Lisa Sue, Lisa PSU. Okay. Yeah, so this, she was at the cafe, let's just put a hypothetical situation. And I saw some pictures and some video footage of these overclocks and what they were getting with the 16 core. And that's all I had seen so far. And they were telling me that this was, you know, because you saw the images, yeah?
Yes.
1.56 volt. That's basically hardcore extreme overclocking. That's not your everyday overclocks. The everyday overclocks was 4.1 gigahertz. Now, that was on an engineering sample. And I was told that was more of a, I guess, the closer to release retail samples as well. And so the clock speeds may come in pretty close to that of the retail samples. But of course, it's the 16 core. No one knows exactly if how that's going to behave versus the 8 core, for instance, or the 6 core, or the 12 core. So my prediction was around 4.4 gigahertz, I think, like when I talked about speculation a while ago. Obviously, you'd heard some of these rumors of 5 gigahertz, all cores. It's going to actually obliterate everything. But I'm just looking at it logically. The 15% IPC improvement, that was super impressive. Like, that is a feat that I was, that spooked me. I was like, wow, AMD have done it.
Right.
That was a big one that I came out of. But the clock speeds, I was kind of like, when people were talking 5 gigahertz, I was a little bit like, eh.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
So, 4.1, that was on the 16 core, but that was an Enjo sample. So 4.2 to 4.4.
You think that's where it's going to land?
For and air of course, and water overclocks.
Let's make sure it's clear, though, because there's not a 16 core part announced. We keep hearing it's the mythical unicorn that's going to show up, but you've seen numbers for it.
We know
it's not here.
Yeah,
we know it exists.
We know it exists. I've heard from other boards, partners, behind the scenes people that, you know, everyone knows the 16 core's out there. But, you know, when it's going to be released. Hey, like I said before, like way before all this stuff was released, that AMD, even if they had a 16 core, they don't need to release that yet on mainstream.
Sure.
Because they don't need them. The competition is.
But they didn't need to do a 16 core Threadripper either, so.
Yeah, but people wanted that. Like, yeah. You know, there's always that market out there that wants 16 cores and they're willing to pay for it.
Right.
So. Whether or not the 16 core mainstream, if people need it yet, and that own product will be eating into AMD's own product stack.
True.
So there's always those arguments there, and you still think about it logically. So, I mean, looking like my prediction was kind of like right on the money. I mean, not going to toot my own horn, but you know what, I will a little bit, because there was all the crap talk in the comments, people saying, you know, go to this guy, you can't trust me, and all that. But I'm just calling it how it is, brother. Just straight down the line. Like, you just see things like the chessboard. What's the best move, you know?
Right, so, right. I get you. It's always good to be right.
Yeah.
Because everybody remembers when I'm wrong.
But yeah, they do, man. Everyone did it if you're wrong.
Your prediction, though, is we're going to maybe see 4.4 when we do see the Unicorn 16?
Again, it's like 4.2 to 4.4. That's my prediction. Okay. Like, all cores. Not your single, like, the single core boost. And that's another thing I'm going to look into is the single core boost. When I've done those tests, they're always bouncing across the cores. Like, it's not a,
yeah, sure.
It's not a true single core boost.
It's not the old days, yes.
Yeah,
it's
so
what you can get out of it at the moment. So.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to the all core speeds because I do a lot of 4K video editing. And you obviously need all those cores at that particular speed. And a lot of enthusiasts love the all-core speeds. So that's what I'm looking forward to. Don't know about yourself.
Yeah, no, it always makes testing easier too. So.
But what's your predictions? Are you going to trust the S?
I like only commenting on parts that are out.
Yeah.
So the 12 is what I'd feel comfortable talking about. The 16, we'll wait. I think it'll be above 4. I think it'll be above 4,
yeah,
but I also think even the 12 core part is going to easily hold above 4 for most of the runs, because in that blender test they did, it easily whooped that 9920XE.
Yeah.
And the 9920XE is like a near 4 all core.
Yeah.
So if we're going to get...
Yeah, I mean, are you going, are we talking like on the same lines here, air and water overclocks, manual?
Yeah, I mean, I almost think, I mean, like with a decent cooler.
Yeah.
So you know, letting it do it automatically.
Like, yeah, I don't know, that's what I mean. So I was sort of, it's weird, hey, right? When you think about it, it could be 4. Like, it could be 4. That's what you could be getting on these chips, and that's sort of like the mainstream overclock. Could be 4.2. Best case scenario, be 4.4. So
on 16.
Well, maybe on 12.
Even on 12.
Depends how it behaves. Okay. If the power consumption's that good, if the efficiency's that good, then it's not really going to matter a whole lot from 12 to 16. So, again, we don't know enough just yet, too. And so that's the things with rumors as well. We don't know enough yet to say, hey, it's going to be this, it's going to be that. We can only really push out, you know, sort of field ball curve throws. I don't even know what I'm saying now.
I get it. But
speculation.
Well, we're going to get you down on paper, 4.4.
No, okay. 16 core.
16 core, all-in-one. All-in-one cooler, so nothing heavy duty. No closed loop, no custom, no liquid helium.
So that's what I mean. And that
low fours,
that's
where
we're going to. But now we're going to, was that Enjo sample a really good Enjo sample? Was it a bad one? And so again, we're looking at best case scenario, we're looking at worst case scenario. And so yeah, if it's if that was a good Enjo sample, your conservative estimate of 4, I think, is going to be bang right on the money. And so no one knows.
But that, and I'm saying with a normal, nothing crazy overclock. So I think
nothing crazy. Yeah, 4. So. 4 would be what you'd expect. Nothing crazy. All course.
All right, you got to go higher. 4.5. We'll say 4.5.
No, 4.4 is like 4.4 is the best case scenario.
Okay.
Yeah. So we do. Yeah. It's always fun to talk about these things, but 4.4 I think is the best case scenario.
Okay.
So
when we get parts, when they're tested, we're gonna come back. We say, hey, what's up? You said I was gonna get it.
No, and I don't want after this. I don't want any like even if how wrong I am or right, whatever. I don't care. Speculation, guys. Take it with a grain of salt.
Okay.
So, but we have seen those images out there. That's what we know. So we can basically base the range around that now. So, there.
Okay.
4.1 all cores. That's what they got.
Okay.
On an over, on an enthusiast sort of level overclock. So.
Okay. It's still pretty good though.
It is.
It's still pretty good.
Well, the 15% IPC. That's the most impressive thing. So.
Right.
And the reduced power consumption, so.
No, it's looking like a good part, so. All right, so come back. When he's wrong, we're going to get on him, folks. I'm just kidding. Anyway, thank
you,
Brian.
I'm nervous now, man, going on this record now.
And again, go check out Tech Yes City, great channel, over on YouTube, and click his bell or something button down here.
The sub button and the bell. You got it nowadays, man.
You got it.
That's like a proper sub nowadays. It's the bell notification now.
Bell and the sub.
Yeah.
The bell and the sub.
You gotta do the lot.